Do you have a plan to increase security in places like that?
The district has up-to-date and well-tested emergency response plans. This program was produced by Lenape District Television.
Hello and welcome to today's field hockey matchup between the Cherokee Chiefs and the Shawnee Renegades. On this beautiful afternoon, I'm Sam Goldberg with Joe Malagrana. And Joe, so what do you think of today's matchup?
Well, I think both teams coming off of last year's records are very similar. Cherokee had 12-9 record, and Shawnee had 12-9-1. I think the main difference today may be, especially in this heat, that the Renegades may have a little bit more of varsity experience on their squad. With that being said, usually we have a great game, and I don't think any different for today.
Well, that's good, and we'll be back with the game right after this.
Today's game on LDTV Sports, sponsored by Deborah Heart and Lung Center, where experience matters. 800-555-1990. www.deborah.org. Philadelphia Wholesale Produce Market. All the best, all right here. 215-336-3003. Or on the web at www.pwpm.net. Comegno Law Group, specializing in general and special education law, representing individuals, families, public boards of education, and independent schools. 888-313-IDEA or comegnolaw.com. Medford Village Car Care, serving the area's car care needs for 30 years. Located at 11 North Main Street in Medford. 609-654-4023. And on the web at mvcc-nj.com. Rothman Institute, the official team physicians of the Phillies, Eagles, Flyers, and 76ers. For orthopedic excellence, think Rothman first. www.rothmaninstitute.com. And by Heads Up, Eyes Forward, please never drive distracted. www.lrhsd.org/heads-up. For information on how your business can become a sponsor of LDTV Sports, contact Joe Malagrana, LDTV Underwriting Manager, at 609-268-2000, extension 8680, or by email, jmalagrana@lrhsd.org.
And hello, welcome today to a beautiful afternoon game here today at Shawnee High School, as we have the Cherokee Chiefs taking on the Shawnee Renegades.
I don't know how beautiful, much beautiful it is. It's like 98 up here in the booth, and the heat index close to 100, but the girls are out there, and they're almost ready to go.
Yeah, it is pretty hot up here, but we'll try and sweat through it. And speaking of that, it is now time for the AXA Keys to the Game. Providing millions of customers with life insurance, annuities, and other needs-based products since 1859. AXA Equitable, be life confident. 732-452-7275. And for Cherokee, They need to execute on corners.
Yeah, yesterday we did the Shawnee Renegades at Cherokee Soccer, and Shawnee, I think, scored three out of their five corners. And for Cherokee to be probably in this game, they're going to have to, rely on the corners and hopefully make do.
And for Shawnee, they need to use speed and width of the field.
Right, they do have a fast team. However, if they don't spread the field, they won't be able to take advantage of that speed. So they do have to spread out the field and use their speed.
And for both teams, they need to be playing together.
Absolutely. Communication in almost any sport is a must, certainly here today. Looks like we're ready to go. Our play-by-play announcer will send it over to Sam Goldberg.
All right, and
just waiting for the whistle here to start on this hot afternoon.
There's the whistle, and looks like a chip into the offensive zone of Shawnee. If that ball goes out, it'll be Shawnee ball. It's going to be chipped into the zone, and it's carefully moving its way, and looks like there was a violation there. Not sure, but, and they're moving in now. Could have turned around and had a shot there, but I'm not sure, but, well, here comes Cherokee now.
Yeah, good defense here by the Chiefs. They bend but didn't break, and as a result, they have a restart on the sideline.
So it'll be a free hit here for Cherokee. And that ball will be drived out to midfield as there's a little battle for the ball. Looks like there was a little violation, so it'll be a free hit for Cherokee. And it's going to be played down to the far side. Back down, and there's a good clearance. Looks like there was another violation called. And the AXA equitable side, it's now time for the AXA equitable sideline report, providing millions of customers with life insurance, annuities, and other needs-based products. Since 1859, AXA equitable, be life confident, 732-452-7275. And now let's send it over to Alyssa with the report.
Thanks, Sam. So I was able to talk to both Shawnee Coach Tolliver and Cherokee Coach Bell, and I talked to them a little bit about their summer prep tactics, and Shawnee is sticking tried and true. They practiced all summer, they had a team camp, and they had a tournament before the preseason, so they have played themselves out all summer. And Cherokee is trying some new techniques. They brought in a strength trainer that prepped the girls mentally and physically, and this year they're trying a quote of the week, which they're using to set a new goal every week that they can work on. So they're going to try and progress as the season goes on. That's two very different approaches to this game, so we'll watch for these influences throughout the rest. Back to you guys.
All right, thank you, Alyssa. And as a whistle just blew, it'll be a free hit for the Shawnee Renegades.
Yeah, and whatever preps the teams have, these two teams are usually ready for the first game, and they certainly are, as we see Cherokee with a restart here.
As the ball is thrown into the middle here, it's out in front of the net. Cherokee turns around, the whistle blows, and it looks like, I'm not sure, it looks like we'll have...
Looks like we're going to have the penalty.
Looks like we'll have a penalty cross here. Yeah, that's what we'll be having. Waiting for the ref to blow the whistle, and here comes the ball in from the cross. It's out in front of the net. The Cherokee's going to take a shot, but there's a nice save by number 80 by the goalie.
That's Gianna Glatz, number 83. Senior goalie for the Renegades, makes a nice stop on that play. As the Renegades will be starting off deep in their defensive zone. Looks like number 21, Victoria Shaw, with the miss it, and I'm sorry, that's number 27, and that is Rachel Winiarsik, one of the captains for Shawnee.
As the ball is in midfield right now,
That's Erica Solomon with the stick handling.
Loses the ball. There was a whistle. It looks like it goes back to Cherokees. The ball's going to be played down the side. And
now that's going to be an evident trip on number 11, one of the captains, Gianna Mancini on Shawnee. Looks like number two, Gab Bodine, will be starting it off for the Chiefs.
There's the hit. Oh, she carried the ball a little bit there. That was impressive.
Yeah, went out on white, so she's going to get it back. Of course, Gab Bodine, also a great lacrosse player for the Chiefs.
She's going to drive the ball in there in the middle. It's going to be kicked away by Gianna Glatz. So there's her second save of the game.
Yeah, Chiefs putting on some pressure last couple minutes here. Going to be starting with number two, Gab Bodine. Oh, that had a hurt.
Got her in the leg, it looked like. There comes the flasher to try and clear the cross, and yeah, she's going to do that beautifully.
Right, instead of passing it out, she decided to try to stick handle
it. That is a beautiful clearance. The ball is free down the sideline. That's going to be, it looks to get cleared by Cherokee, but Shawnee comes back on the attack. Number 15 had it, but lost it for a moment.
Number 15 is one of the captains, Sabrina Solomon.
Ball goes to Gianna Martin, or Mancini, as whistle's going to blow. And it looks like it's going to be a Shawnee free hit. So Sabrina Solomon now has the ball. She's stick handling her way through the Cherokee defense.
Yeah, she was stick handling through three chases.
There's a shot on goal. It's out in front of the net, kicked away. Kicked away by the goalie.
We got a whistle going back to the Chiefs, but such great pressure there by the Renegades.
So it looks like the ball's going to be played out far. And the ball's going to go out in front.
It's number one, I believe, Ashley Wetzel.
Ashley Wetzel has it. It's going to go out in front.
Oh, and it went in.
That is a goal. Didn't quite exactly saw who scored that.
Yeah, no, I know. I kind of
she just raised her hand, and Sabrina Solomon comes up with the goal.
Okay, again, senior captain forward, Sabrina Solomon, with the first goal of the year and of the game. Puts Renegades up 1-0.
The ball just kind of slightly slid past the goalie for Cherokee.
Well, might have been a little bit of a deflection and any kind of, you know, change of speed. Managed to get it into the net, and that's all that counts.
Uh-huh.
You see number 23, Lindsay Florio, carrying it down the right side for the Chiefs.
Weaves. Two defenders there is...
That was Christina Oria, one of the other captains for the Chiefs, but the Renegades do have the ball.
There's a free hit by Rachel Winikarski. As it's going to be Cherokee possession now. As there's a thing into the box. It's in the middle. And it's cleared away. As another whistle blows. Looks like there was a violation, and it looks like it'll be... Not sure exactly what it is at the moment. Looks like I'm pretty sure it'll just be a free hit. Well, they'll bring it back into middle field. And it's in the middle here, as it'll be cleared away again by Sabrina Solomon. So it's pretty good, and now... Ashley Wetzel was carrying the ball for a moment.
Managed to draw a whistle, so they're going to Renegades are going to keep possession. It's number 11. Gianna Mancini starts.
She had a free hit there. It was played. It got a deflection, and looks like it'll be a Shawnee free hit, I'm not sure. And as we say this, it is now time. Let's take a look at the Ivy Rehab replay. Ivy Rehab Physical Therapy on the web at ivyrehab.com. So as we look slow motion here as the replay, so yeah, that was most certainly Sabrina Solomon with the goal.
Right, and even with slow motion, it might have changed directions or speeds just a little bit to get past the Cherokee's goaltender. We're not sure who is in the nets for the Chiefs, and we find that out. We'll pass that along.
As the ball is freely played right now by Rachel Winikarski at midfield, and then it's passed up to Gianna Marcini, and she's in a really good battle right now, as it'll be a Cherokee free hit.
Yeah, I think they had that leg wrapped around. That's why it went to Cherokee.
So is the Cherokee free hit's going to be played? It's going to be played out to Gigi Glenning. And Gigi Glenning still has the ball, but then there's another whistle. It'll be another free hit for Cherokee, and that'll be taken by Joelle Walsh, as she is one of the captains of Cherokee. And there was a nice spin move by Solomon, but then it gets taken away, and now it's carried by Allison Yoakum, and then she lost it. And now it's going to be a Shawnee free hit.
I think a defender there, Bella Mancini, number 44, interrupted that play.
We went on the free hit. It's going to be chipped in the air. It's passed, and now Erica Solomon has it. She gives it up to Sabrina Solomon as Cherokee will drill.
Yeah, draw the violation. It'll go back to the Chiefs. A lot of action back and forth in both teams so far, with a little under 20 minutes gone.
So far, so good. This is a really nice-looking game.
Very entertaining game to this point. You're absolutely right, mm-hmm. Sam.
And there's another violation. This will be another Cherokee free hit. That free hit will be taken by Victoria Shaw as the ball's out to center midfield. That was passed by Kelly Foley. And then Allison Yoakum had it taken away. So it'll be another free hit here for Shawnee. So that free hit was taken by Bella Mancini. There was a little battle out of midfield. And Cherokee gets a free hit. And now it's drawn up field. And then Shawnee takes it away. So now here come the Renegades charging. And Renegades will have another free hit.
Big battle there on the right side.
Action fast and furious now. As here comes Shawnee on a really high-paced attack, but then Cherokee tries to clear it, and they will successfully clear it. That ball being thrown up to midfield. That was off Lindsay Florio of Cherokee, but then she had it taken away because it hit off her foot. And then Gianna Mancini will throw it down the sideline, but then there will be a free hit whistle as Cherokee looks to gain possession back here. That'll be beautifully taken away by Gianna Mancini. Now there's a lot of open space right there for Colette Azusian.
Okay, that would be Colette Exusion. I only know that because I had a lot of them in class here at the Blue School for many years. We have Chiefs on the restart here.
Looks to be a free hit.
I should correct myself, Sam. In the pre-game, I said that Shawnee's last year record was 12-9-1. They were 11-7-1. Apologize for that. I could blame it on the heat. Going to be a lot of that today.
Yeah, it is hot up here. As the Cherokee free hit is misplaced, but there is a whistle. It'll be a Shawnee thing, but before the play can resume, whistle stops again. And Sabrina Solomon has the ball again. She's going to try and maneuver between two Cherokee defenders.
Yeah, tried to break the double team, but it didn't work. And as Cherokee gets another whistle here.
So that ball will be played as Cherokee will come up with it back to midfield, but then that attack will be stopped by Rachel Winizarski.
Yeah,
and then here comes Cherokee again.
Fast and furious action here.
There's another battle. And then it's still battled for, and finally, after all this action, it'll come out to a Shawnee free hit, and it's going to be played fast up the field. And there's another battle for it. And then there's a whistle. It'll be a Cherokee free hit. And that ball's ripped down, and then it turns onto a 1v, one-on-one here, but Shawnee is going to clear the ball.
Yeah, the pass was just a little bit up ahead. That was a great chance of a scoring opportunity for the Chiefs. They keep possession here, Sam.
And the deflection went off of Shawnee, and it'll be a free hit here for Cherokee, but that was intercepted there by Erica Solomon.
Yeah, again, the Cherokee player was stickling it out. As soon as she started that, the Shawnee Renegades is right on her.
So Shawnee trying to keep up the attack here. They've been having Cherokee on their heels. There's a nice move, but there's a nice move by Sabrina Solomon, but she had it taken away. Now it's back to midfield as it's played by Rachel, and then she has it taken away. Now here comes Cherokee on the offensive attack, and then that's cleared away. But then there's another nice steal. So fast and furious action here. She gets as Joelle Walsh gets tripped up.
Right, and I think we're going to have a water break because of this heat. And I know they did this in a soccer game yesterday, where there's, especially in soccer, there's usually no timeouts unless there's a goal scored, or an injury. But because of the undue amount of heat, we will be having some, similar to yesterday's game, a water break, and that's what we have here right now. Since we do have time, we're going to mention the captains again for Cherokee Chief is Lily Fox, Joelle Walsh, Christina Oreo, and for the Renegades, Gianna Mancini, Sabrina Solomon, Colette Exclusion, and Rachel Minarsik. So we have, again, about 14 minutes and 38 seconds gone or left in the first half. 1-0 Shawnee, but there have been, two or three minutes. Each team's had some offensive possession and some fairly good scoring opportunities, but up until this point, it's only 1-0.
Yeah, and as you can see here, there's the Shawnee Renegades huddle. Got to rehydrate in this heat.
Absolutely. I know we said we were hot up here in the press box, but I walked across the field twice, and again you have the turf field with the little rubber particles in there, and I always say that the temperature on the field is usually at least 10 to 15 degrees hotter than the actual air temperature. So a lot of breaks today is definitely going to be needed, that's for sure.
Yeah, we might need to take a water break ourselves. It's so hot up here.
If you guys don't hear anything, we're drinking some water. Brother. And, of course, the coaches for Cherokee's first-year head coach is Devin Bell, although she was an assistant coach at Cherokee the past 2 years, and she also played at Cherokee and also at Ball State University. And for Shawnee, longtime coach Renee Tolliver, this is her 11th year as head coach. She has an amazing record of 164, 46 losses, and 5 ties. She played at Lenape and also went to Rowan University and helped win the first women's national championship in 2002. So we got fine, impressive resumes in both coaches and great talent on both teams.
That is a really impressive record for Renee Tolliver. Really impressive. And it looks like Action's going to resume here as soon as all players are ready. So not sure how they're going to break this. It looks like...
Cherokee had possession, and the refs decided that it was around the time where, they were going to break for the water break, so it goes back to Cherokee.
So Joel Walsh just had a free hit there, but then it had it taken away by Solomon, and now it's played to Sam Patrizzi, and then the ball carried up to mid. It'll be in the offensive zone as it was about to go up, but it was saved by a Cherokee player. Not sure who that was at the moment, but as the ball keeps getting carried and there's a violation, so it'll be a free hit for Shawnee as it's played into the box here. Oh. That's in, and
what a kick save.
That was a unbelievable save.
And again, we're not sure who's in net for the Chiefs, but we have a break. We'll try to find that out and pass that along. In any case, that was a great kick save, a little bit of redirection. Kept her head down, kept her eyes on the ball, and a great save for the Chiefs to keep it 1-0 for Shawnee.
And there's a free hit there for Shawnee. As Cherokee looks to clear the ball here, but it's stopped by Shawnee, and it looks like it was hit. As it'll be thrown in here. As it is in the middle, but there is a whistle. There's the Cherokee plays the ball to the far side. It'll be thrown still down the far side. And Shawnee coming back on the attack, but there's another violation.
Yeah, we had a number of whistles the last 30 or 40 seconds that interrupt any kind of flow that either team has had.
So far it's been a really low-scoring game as of right now, with action fast and furious as here come the Renegades now back on the attack. That's beautiful stick handle, but there's a whistle as Erica Solomon will draw a foul. And then Cherokee looked to clear the ball here, but it stopped, and there's another whistle.
Yet another whistle on the Chiefs, and hopefully they don't go into the well too often here.
There's the ball trying to be played in, and there's yet another whistle, but it will be a Cherokee free hit as that ball's going to be played to the near side, but just out of the reach of Gab Bodine. And she will save the ball, but it will be played to Gianna Mancini as she will carry the ball. Beautiful stick handling. It'll be drawn to the far near side for Ashley Wetzel, and there's a whistle, and it looks like there will be a penalty cross coming in.
And that was drawn out. Number seven, Charis Hickey, was staying wide, and that was one of our keys to the game, to use the Shawnee speed with the wide field, and she certainly was wide and drew the penalty.
As to take the penalty cross, Bella Mancini will take the penalty cross. As here it comes, it's in front. There was a nice drive there by Sabrina Solomon, who tried to look for a second goal of the game, but that was sticked away.
Yeah, and I think it was sticked away by Katie Copper, number seven. Great job by the Chiefs defense on that.
And then looks like there was another whistle, and it was played to the far side, but it looks like the pass was too far out as it'll be a free hit for Shawnee. It'll be flagged down. The Kitty Copper. And now it's to mid. And now here comes Cherokee on the attack. They have somebody wide open on the far side, but pretty sure they couldn't see that on the attack as it gets taken away. Now it's a free hit for Shawnee. So a brief moment there.
That was a
for
great,
Cherokee.
It was a great pass by Bodine in the middle of the field. Unfortunately, they couldn't keep it going, but had the ball back. Now Shawnee regains possession.
This ball will be thrown to the far side, and right now, Colette.
Excusion.
Has the ball. Now the ball is thrown out in front. And there was a shot, but it took a redirect. And
want to go against the Renegades.
Yeah, and so now it'll be a Cherokee free hit. Did I ever tell you I wasn't good with names? Never been good with names.
Well, it's not too easy, you know. I'm okay with a lot of vowels.
As a Cherokee free hit was taken away by Claire Flannery. As she'll lose the ball, now Cherokee will have the ball near side. Lindsay Florio has the ball, but she'll lose it, and then Shawnee will get a free hit.
It's Rachel Minarchik restarting for Renegades.
That's a nice looking pass, but it will be taken away by Cherokee, and looks like the ball hit someone. So it also will blow. So it will be a free hit for Shawnee.
That's number 38, Olivia Drea, for the Renegades as we start.
The ball is on the far side as it's played. It's tipped by a Cherokee defender, and oh, beautiful stick handling. It's out in front. She's going to take the shot, and she scores.
Short side, too.
What a stick handle goal. That goal was scored by Colette.
Excusion.
That was a really beautiful goal. Beautiful stick handling to get the ball out in front.
Yeah, hopefully, yes. Sam, we'll get a replay on that because I think everybody, including us up here, thought she was going to pass. And
yeah,
she went short side, and they give Shawnee a big 2-0 lead. There's a little more than 8 minutes left in the first half. Great effort there by the Renegades.
Yeah, it's Cherokee needs to get something going here.
Yeah, the next goal will really be important if Cherokee can pop it in, knock that lead in half.
Yes, indeed. There's a free hit by Shawnee, played out to midfield. That is, not sure who that was, the ball out in midfield, but it'll be cleared away by Cherokee. And there's a violation on Cherokee, so Shawnee will get a free hit. So the free hit's tipped, and then there's another violation, but then Shawnee's going to move in. Has the ball. There's the cross in. Still out in front. There's a shot, but it goes wide.
It looked like there was also a little bit of a deflection, but fortunately for the Chiefs, it went wide of the net. That third goal would have been tough to come back, even though we do have a lot of time left. And you always have to think about the effects of this weather having on the girls out there.
It looks like there was a substitution there for Cherokee as well, as Gigi Glenning comes back into the game for Lindsay Florio. There was a little bit of aggressive play there by Katie Copper.
Right, and draws the whistle where Olivia Dre is going to restart for the Renegades. She pushes it back, changes fields.
That goes out, and then there's a nice pass to midfield as here come the Renegades again. Keeping their offensive tempo up.
That ball came up, so it's going to go to the Chiefs.
And looks like there was a little bit of a stick thing there with one of the Shawnee Renegades hitting the ball away from Cherokee as the ball has thrown into the middle again. It's out in front, and then another kick save by the Cherokee goalie. As it will be a free hit for Cherokee as it goes out on Shawnee.
Coming down to a little less than 6 minutes. Shawnee again holding on to that 2-0 lead. And they've been pressuring the Chiefs the last few minutes. Chiefs are having a little bit of trouble getting it past midfield.
But now,
interception here.
But now here come the Chiefs.
A lot of numbers
here. It's out
here
in front, and it's, oh, beautiful save. Another save. It's still out in front. Beautiful saves. by Gianna Glatz.
Gianna Glatz just had four saves in a matter of 6 seconds. Absolutely fantastic.
So the ball's thrown in again, and there's another kick save. So it's five saves in a matter of 12 seconds. That is unbelievable.
Great job. As soon as I said that Cherokee had trouble passing midfield, they had six great scoring opportunities. But alas, Gianna Glatz stood tall.
As now it'll be...
Looks like the Chiefs are going to get the penalty.
For the Chiefs, we have Lana Tonzello taking the penalty cross. As we're waiting for her to throw it in, as it goes in, it's out. Beautiful move. Cherokee takes a shot, and it goes in. There's a goal. Beautiful shot and a beautiful redirection. Not sure who scored that. We'll have to go to the replay for that, but there's, as Cherokee scores, they cut the deficit one.
Just like that, they cut the deficit in half. And after all of the great saves, again, you don't need a lot. There's just a little bit of redirection to get the goalie off of her game. And we got a game here, 2-1.
Yeah, so after seven beautiful saves by Gianna Glatz, she finally lets one in as Shawnee still has the lead 2-1. And as we speak of Shawnee, they're on the attack again, trying to keep the attack on.
Yeah, well, Shawnee wants to get that momentum right back after giving up a goal. Sometimes, you know, you kind of lay back after a goal, but they're on the attack once again.
Yeah, let's see. So as we just got word, that last goal scored by Cherokee was number 2, Gab Bodine.
And that's not surprising. She scores a lot in lacrosse and also field hockey.
As Cherokee tries to look to clear the ball out of the zone when it's poked away. And then Solomon has the ball again. There's a violation. And it will be...
for Shawnee.
Another penalty cross for Shawnee. So Shawnee back on the attack again. They've seemed to be unfazed by that goal. As Bella Mancini will be taking the penalty cross. As here's the cross. It's in play, but it's mishandled. And the ball will be sent back into the zone. Cherokee tried to clear it, and they draw a whistle, and it'll be Cherokee ball.
And that was number 50, Claire Flannery, that kept it deep and sent it back in. But unfortunately, whistle gives it right back to Cherokee, but Shawnee gets it right back again.
So Shawnee coming fast and furious. This goal that was scored on them seems to be unfazed. They seem to be unfazed by it. And there's another whistle. So whistles coming really fast here in the game.
You're right, and the restarts by the Renegades. They're trying to get an edge with a quick one, but the refs didn't have anything to do with that one. They had to reset it up. Sometimes you can get away with it.
As the ball will be played into the middle, it's still in front, and there's a whistle. So yet another whistle, and that kind of destroyed the Shawnee attack there, but it's knocked down again by Shawnee. It looks like Shawnee will have the ball again. And there's a... in the offensive zone, she's going to take a... I don't know who that was, but it's still out in front. It's going to be backhand. There's a kick save. It's still out in front. Another kick save by the Cherokee goalie. There's another whistle.
And there's 1 minute left. They're 1:30 on the scoreboard anyway. I'm just assuming that this is a water break or possibly a warning on the player. It looks like a yellow card, I think.
Not sure. But however, some time did run off the clock, and there's a minute and 19 seconds left. As that'll look to get reset. So, Kais, we have no idea what the call is as of right now. But
yeah, the referees are getting together, and again, we can just speculate. Thought it was a water break, but it was kind of odd with 1 minute and 30 seconds left to have a water break. And then possibly we thought that there was going, you know, to be a warning or a card on a player. And now we're not sure.
I just had a water break myself.
There we
but,
go.
I'll
drink to that.
As still don't know what the call was on the field. I think there might have been a card. Not entirely sure.
Well, in any case, it looks like
Like there'll be a face-off here.
Okay, maybe it was a missed call. That's why they're having the face-off. But I think they're going over maybe correcting the clock.
As the clock has been reset, and there's a minute and 30 seconds left to go.
Right, and
referee blows her whistle.
Did see the ref looking at her watch, so she, even though the scoreboard's here, she may be keeping the official time on the field. As Shawnee's trying to get that third goal with a little bit more than a minute here.
Yeah, as they're on the attack again, and yet another whistle, as there will be another penalty cross. So we have 1 minute left here in the first. As the penalty cross will be thrown in. It's handled. It's passed. There's a shot, but it's deflected away. So great defense. As that was some really good defense by Cherokee. I'm not sure who hit that out.
Yeah,
but that was really good defense.
As many chances Renegades have, the Cherokee defense has been standing up pretty tall, just letting the two deflected goals in. It's under a minute here.
And so now here comes Shawnee again on the attack. So Shawnee's first half, relentless attack, beautiful stick handling out in front. And Shawnee will draw another whistle, as it'll be another penalty cross. 1 minute left. And I believe it'll be a penalty cross here. That penalty cross will be taken by Bella Mancini.
That's about the fifth or sixth in the last few minutes for the Renegades. Don't know how much time is left. It's kept on the field under a minute.
As the cross comes in, taken by Solomon. Solomon will pass it away. It'll go back to Solomon. Solomon with a shot. It'll saved out in front by the Cherokee goalie. And Cherokee tries to clear it. There's another shot by Solomon. It'll be deflected by Cherokee. And it'll go out, and it'll be another penalty cross. So, again, high-tempoed offense for Shawnee. But Cherokee standing tall, as there was a beautiful save out in front by the Cherokee goalie.
Just relentless pressure here with not much time left, 1 o'clock.
And here's the cross coming in, and it's played up top. Cherokee trying to... As beautiful defense.
Time runs out, I believe.
And first ends. First half ends. As Shawnee will take a 2... will go into the half with a 2-1 lead.
My God, we usually don't have a lot of scoring in field hockey. But with this high-powered, high-speed offense of Shawnee, we expect more than a one-goal discrepancy. But, you know, both goalies have come up with some huge saves, even though most likely Shawnee has a little bit of the edge on the time of possession and the penalty crosses. But we have a ball game, 2-1 in this heat, and it's got to be taking its toll down there, that's for sure.
Yeah, as you just saw there, Cherokee coach Devin Bell trying to rally her troops together, as that is the end of the first half, as the Shawnee Renegades have the 2-1 advantage over the Cherokee Chiefs on this really hot afternoon. As we will We will be back right after this.
Today's game on LDTV Sports, sponsored by Deborah Heart and Lung Center, where experience matters. 800-555-1990. www.deborah.org. Philadelphia Wholesale Produce Market. All the best, all right here. 215-336-3003. Or on the web at www.pwpm.net. Comegno Law Group, specializing in general and special education law, representing individuals, families, public boards of education, and independent schools. 888-313-IDEA or comegnolaw.com. Medford Village Car Care, serving the area's car care needs for 30 years. Located at 11 North Main Street in Medford. 609-654-4023. And on the web at mvcc-nj.com. Rothman Institute, the official team physicians of the Phillies, Eagles, Flyers, and 76ers. For orthopedic excellence, think Rothman first. www.rothmaninstitute.com. And by Heads Up, Eyes Forward, please never drive distracted. www.lrhsd.org/heads-up. For information on how your business can become a sponsor of LDTV Sports, contact Joe Malagrana, LDTV Underwriting Manager, at 609-268-2000, extension 8680, or by email, jmalagrana@lrhsd.org.
Lunch and Learn is new, but it's a lot of fun and it gives a lot of opportunities for kids to do what they want with their time. I do a lot of my homework and I study a lot during Lunch and Learn, and I can also socialize with a lot of different groups of friends.
I really like it, and it seems like the students really like it too. It's nice to have a longer period to eat. That's always wonderful. But then it can also be used for other things like lab time, meeting with students for extra help, giving a test or quiz makeup, or club meetings too. So that's made it really useful.
I'm personally a fan of Lunch and Learn because during it you can have meetings with different clubs and everything. And being an athlete, it's hard to make meetings after school, so it frees up my time after school for that.
There's movement throughout the building, so they may eat in one spot and then migrate to a different area. They're getting a lot of stuff done. Some of them are just hanging out and just having some downtime in their day too, which I think our kids really need.
They don't have to be nervous about like who's in their lunch period or not having any friends like in their actual lunch, because everybody has lunch at the same time.
There's a lot less stress. There's a lot less pressure to, you know, rush through your lunch and worry about getting to your next class on time, because you now have so much more time and you can relax a lot more.
In the past, it was just such a race for students to get down to the cafeteria and actually get a meal and sit down and eat.
Sometimes you would be in line the entire time and you would get 5 minutes to eat. So this is a lot better. There's a lot more time.
I think the students really like it. They like having that break in the middle of the day to get caught up on homework, get ready for the next class, get things done. It is amazing to see how many students are actually, you know, in the media center or in the cafeteria using the time to get some work done.
It gives you that extra time that you might need with a teacher if you need to go over a lesson one more time.
Lunch and Learn has given us a lot of flexibility in what we're able to do to meet with students who want to come in and study, go over questions, problems, whatever it might be, when they might not ordinarily be able to come in before school or after school.
It's a great opportunity for students to have that one-on-one tutoring, even if it's only for 5 minutes or it's for the full 50 minutes. They're able to come in and ask for help on anything, whether it's homework or an upcoming quiz or a test.
Having lunch in the middle of the day makes me feel a lot more refreshed when I go back for the second half, and it's like the second half goes by a lot faster, I feel like, because you've had this big break right in the middle of it, so it's good.
I do feel a lot more refreshed just because I get to relax a little bit instead of just rushing from one class to the other.
It gives us more time to unwind, look at like previous classes in the day, and also plan ahead for future classes that we have.
This year's schedule definitely gives us a lot more freedom. I mean, you have to kind of make the best use of your time between eating, studying, going to clubs, getting extra help, and then like just socializing with your friends. And I think it really has like made students more independent with their time.
I think Lunch and Learn does help prepare students for college, especially because college is all about time management. So it allows them to have kind of that freedom during the school day to start practicing those skills of, all right, I have an hour of my time to do anything I want. Am I going to prioritize schoolwork? Am I going to prioritize socializing? And they can start to make those decisions in a high school setting.
As we'd like to welcome you back here to Shawnee High School, as the Shawnee Renegades have the 2-1 advantage over the Cherokee Chiefs. As now it is time for the AXA Equitable Sideline Report, providing millions of customers with life insurance, annuities, and other needs-based products since 1859. AXA Equitable. Be life confident. 732-452-7275. And now let's send it over to Alyssa Biederman with the report.
Thanks. So I was able to talk to Cherokee's coach, Bell, and it's very close, especially with that last goal by Cherokee. And I actually found out Cherokee's quote of the week, which is, you've got what it takes, but it takes everything that you've got. And that just goes to show Cherokee's really taken that to heart. They've got great enthusiasm and spirit throughout the game. And they're really living up to this motto, even in this crazy heat. And they refuse to give up, and there's still another 30 minutes, so it's very close, and we will see who wins. Back to you guys.
All right, thank you, Alyssa. So we just got word. We found out that Alma Altenberg was the first half goalie for Cherokee, as the second half is about to start.
All right, it looks like we do have a change of goalies for the second half. It's going to be Allie St. Jean.
As now it is time to take a look at some Ivy Rehab replays. Ivy Rehab Physical Therapy on the web at ivyrehab.com. As here's the first goal. So I'm almost positive this was Sabrina Solomon, as I think... I'm not entirely sure about that last one, but here's a shot that looked like it was going to go in and then beautifully kicked away by Emma Altenberg.
Right, she kicked it away, flicked it into the corner, so there was no rebound.
That Shawnee goal right there by Coletti. Sam Patrizzi.
No, that would be Colette Excusion, I believe, number 22 on the second goal, as we're...
As then here, as... Oh, yeah. I thought that got redirected by number 13 of Cherokee. And then here, as we have Gianna Glatz coming up with some amazing saves.
Like, right, there were about 4 or 5 in 6 seconds. Beautiful.
And
a big save by Cherokee.
And then here's the big save by Cherokee. So she kicks it away, and that was huge.
Right at the whistle to end the first half. Yeah, we're not sure at halftime. I went down and found out, and they feel that Christina Oria did get a piece of that. So right now we're told otherwise, we're unfortunately taking the goal away from Gab Bodine, who set that up. And it might have deflected off of the stick of Christina Oria. So right now, the one goal for the Chiefs goes to Christina Oria. If there's any change on that, we'll pass that along. Again, to our play-by-play announcer, Mr. Sam Goldberg.
As action still fast and furious coming out of the gate, as Shawnee has another opportunity, but a whistle blows, as it'll be a Cherokee free hit. That free hit will be taken by Joel Walsh, as that'll be sent high. That was a really high
hit. Yeah, that's going to get called back. And Shawnee's going to have possession.
As it'll be played to the near side, it'll be carried by...
That's Claire Flannery, number 50 for the Renegades.
She's still battling and...
Still going to keep it.
Still gets a free hit, so really good work out of Claire. As, I mean, another free hit here for Colette. As the ball goes out, and it will be a free hit for Shawnee. So it looks like right now, after the, as we're into the second half, it looks like the heat does not seem to be a factor for the Shawnee offense.
No, it certainly doesn't, and that's amazing, because I went down on the field at halftime to clear up the goalie situation and a goal scored. There's a breeze down there. Actually felt better than up here in the booth, but the heat was like fire going through my shoes, so I imagine what they feel like running on that turf.
As the ball will be played near side, as there's another whistle. So, here's a Shawnee free hit taken by Solomon that tried to be brought down by Ashley Wetzel. She still has the ball, still trying to get it through the zone, and there's another whistle, and it'll be a Cherokee free hit. So, action fast and furious coming out here in the second half. The ball will be taken to the far side. Not sure who played that pass down the line, and that ball will go out of bounds.
And Sam, the next goal, even though we have plenty of time, is going to be a big one.
Yes, indeed. So there's another battle going on, and then yet another whistle, as there's a free hit by Shawnee. As
it's called exclusion again.
As the ball, she's still has that in front. She's going to rip a shot.
Oh!
It gets deflected by Ashley Wetzel, and Ashley Wetzel comes up with a huge third goal for Shawnee.
And that's almost impossible to stop. It was just a one-touch redirection. Again, the goalie for the second half is Allie St. Jean, and she didn't have a chance at it. That's really difficult to stop, a 1-2 deflection. Big first goal of the second half goes to the Renegades.
Yeah, so as you called it, you said the third next goal will
next
be a
goal.
Huge one. 30 seconds after, we have a goal. So, I don't know. Should you call out more? I don't know.
I don't know. If this is lucky, we'll go to Atlantic City after the game. You know? Oh, wait a minute. We got a football game to do tonight, too.
Oh, yeah. By the way, I'm too young for Atlantic City. But anywho.
I'm not going to say I can sneak in, but I won't say it then. Okay, we're not talking about Atlantic City. We're talking about Shawnee High School and the Cherokee Chiefs.
As the ball, as Shawnee, still, here they come on the offensive zone. As there's a shot ripped and a nice save there by Allie St. Jean. As the ball will still be played in front, as there's, they try to get another shot on there. As it will be another whistle, and it looks like it'll be a Cherokee free hit. There's the Cherokee free hit as it's played out to the far side, and it's not deflected, so it'll be Shawnee ball. As I believe she whiffed on that. I don't know if that was a fake or not, but anywho, Shawnee comes back on the attack. Played. And it looks like there's another whistle, and there's another whistle on Cherokee, so it'll be another Shawnee hit. As another battle for the ball, and there's yet another whistle, so it'll be another Shawnee free hit. As Claire Flannery takes it into the corner, passes it to the three, and that'll be out in front, but then there's another whistle.
And a quick restart by Cherokee, but they lose it out of bounds. Gives it right back to number 44, Bella Mancini.
So action fast and furious coming in as there's Colette, but she stopped by a whistle. And it'll be a Cherokee ball, but then that's misplayed. And then it's back out in front for Ashley Wetzel. Ashley had the ball out in front, but then she lost it. And then it goes out to Joelle Walsh, who will send it long. Or tried to send it long, but then it gets taken away by Rachel Winozarski, but then that ball gets taken away as it'll go out of bounds and the ball goes to Cherokee. And there's another whistle, so then the ball will go back to Cherokee after Shawnee tried to take it away.
That last offensive push by the Renegades, there's some great passing.
And there's a free hit for Cherokee as the ball bounces backwards a little bit, but Claire Flannery has no problem handling it, she'll clear it. And that ball gets passed up to Collette, and as she's looking around, she'll pass it back to Claire Flannery. Claire will cross it into the box. It's out in front, and as Allie St. Jean comes out to kick it away, but then it goes back out to Claire. She's in a battle. That ball will be tipped, and looks like another whistle. As Claire Flannery will take the hit, as she'll pass it back, number 44, and then that ball will get thrown into the box by Bella Mancini, and then a whistle will be a Cherokee free hit. Let's take a look at the Ivy Rehab replay. Ivy Rehab Physical Therapy on the web at ivyrehab.com. As this was the last goal, as
that's good. Collette Exclusion passing it in.
And then you talk about being at the right place at the right time.
Stick on the ground, redirected right into the net by Ashley Wetzel. Great play.
As you said, Joe, the next goal will be a huge one. As so far, it looks like this goal will be a huge one. But here comes Cherokee now on offense possession. It'll be thrown out in front as it's still out in front. Somebody's got to have it. It's still out in front. It's thrown back into the box, tipped away, as another huge save by Gianna Glatz.
Unbelievable.
Holy moly.
Out of pressure again, like two or three shots that she saved. She was practically on her back making some of those saves and keeps it at a 3-1 game for the Renegades.
Here comes Cherokee back on the attack. That was Lindsay Florio trying to bring it in as Cherokee draws a whistle and it looks like there will be a penalty cross. So now it looks like the heat not affecting Cherokee as they come in, rushing in on offense, realizing that they need two goals to tie this thing up.
All right, if they pop one in here, though, again, they'll only be one behind, and still anybody's game. Plenty of time left.
So here comes the cross in. And there was a mishandled pass and then cleared away by Shawnee. Now here comes Shawnee on the far side, charging in.
Plenty of space.
They have a lot of room. Looks like Erica Solomon got a little bit tired.
All right, and a great play. Number 26, Gigi Glenning, did not give up on the play. I mean, Shawnee has possession, but broke up that great scoring opportunity for the Renegades, but they still have control right here.
Yes, sir.
Another whistle. I think it's going to stay with Shawnee.
As the hit will be taken by Gianna Mancini, as she will carry it, dribbles through three defenders, beautiful stick handling. It's still out in front, but another whistle blows up the Shawnee offense in possession. So whistles kind of destroying some offensive possessions here for both Cherokee and Shawnee. But it looks like the whistle went against Cherokee.
Right, they're going to get probably their seventh or eighth penalty cross here.
Yeah, so here's the cross coming in. Cross is in. A missed hat, a fake shot. There's a beautiful shot, but then another save by Allie St. Jean. So, action coming fast and furious here in the second half.
Okay, we have a stop in the play, and I believe we are going to get a card. Looks like it's going to be on number 23, Erica Solomon.
It looks like she'll be...
Thinks he jumped the gun on the restart, possibly. And next possession, she can get back into the game.
So Cherokee trying to clear the ball out of the offensive zone as they finally win. Oh, no. It's knocked down by Shawnee. So there's a nice little battle there on the far side to gain possession of the ball as Cherokee comes out with it. But do you think the Cherokee players right now are feeling a little bit of pressure to get back into this game?
Well, anytime you're behind, especially against Shawnee, yeah, there's going to be a little bit of pressure. And again, we mentioned it many times that the weather's certainly not helping.
And meanwhile, Solomon carrying the ball into the offensive zone, but then has it taken away by Cherokee. And now Cherokee on the near side, looking to come up with an offensive possession here, as it's beautifully handled by Allison Yoakum.
Yeah, she had a lot of time with that possession, but it's given up.
As Claire Flannery will take it away. And then there's Colette.
Excusion. You go Colette, I'll go Excusion.
Okay. As the ball looked to be hit out by Cherokee. So, looks like to be Shawnee's ball. As Claire Flannery will have the ball. As it's hit to Bella Mancini, she's still stick handling the ball well. As she still has it. Beautiful moves, but that ball will go out and Cherokee will take possession. So a good strong defensive possession here for Cherokee, but Shawnee again back on the attack, but then Joelle Walsh will have the steal, and then here comes Cherokee, but then Shawnee, again, great defense, will take it away.
That's good defense there by number 38, Olivia Drea.
And then that'll go up to Ashley Wetzel, who has the ball, and then she'll pass it back to Gianna Mancini, and she'll throw the ball long, nearly misplayed by Solomon, still handling the ball beautifully, but then sticks get tangled, and it looks like there'll be another penalty cross for Shawnee. It's their ninth, I believe.
And the goalie really is going to have to come up big on these to save these penalties.
As Bella Mancini will take the cross, the penalty cross. As here it comes. Here's a fake shot. Played out to Solomon. It's out in front. It's tipped in. It goes off the post. Still in the middle. It's out in front. There's a couple of whiff shots. And the whistle will finally blow. So almost 4-1 Shawnee as it ricochets off the post.
As they say, goal post is the goaltender's best friend. In that case, that was true.
And meanwhile, Cherokee looking to get on the board here as they have an offensive possession as the whistle blows again. It'll be Cherokee ball.
We have number 14 coming in for the Renegades. And
as it's played out in front, it's out in front and nearly got a shot on goal by Gab Bodine. She nearly had a second goal, but missed the ball as there's another whistle as Cherokee will get possession again. So Cherokee having a nice offensive possession here. And there is a trip, but the whistle goes the other way as it's Cherokee ball.
A little bit of pressure by the Chiefs here now.
Yeah, they're realizing that they're down 3-1 and they need to get back into this. There's a shot. Looks like it deflected as it'll be Cherokee ball. As this replay, as Cherokee coming in clutch, but that post, man, coming in clutch there for Allie St. Jean.
And again, that replay is by Ivy Rehab. We thank them for their sponsorship as we are going to have our first water timeout. Halfway through the second half, it looks like we're going to have one at each half at the halfway point. But again, Sam, like you said many times, fast and furious action on both ends. Boy, that ball goes in, and you know, it's 4-1. It's going to be even more difficult for Cherokee to get back in the game. But just off the post, keeps them in the game, only down 2 with 14 minutes and 40 seconds left in the second half. Just great, great action on both teams.
As you see, Devin Bell trying to talk to her Chiefs about getting back into this game, about having stronger offensive possessions, because they have been shut down here in the second half.
Yeah, the quality scoring chances for the Chiefs haven't been that many, so I'm sure she's telling them, said, look, there's 14 minutes left. We have a chance. We have to do something with it. As we see Devin Bell, first season's head coach. She does have only 6 returning starters from 2015, so they lost a few starters. They have a fairly good amount of veterans and experienced and inexperienced players, but I tell you, you couldn't tell the difference up here, because both teams are really certainly putting on a great performance in this ungodly heat today.
Yes, indeed. As Cherokee trying to push now to get some goals. As now we go over to Renee Tolliver, as this is her 11th season as head coach. And that's a long time as a head coach. I mean, she has a lot of success. As we go back, and her record, really impressive. 164 wins, 46 losses, and only 5 ties. So that's a really impressive record.
Absolutely. And she's carrying on from a Hall of Fame coach, Bobby Schultz, here than many, many years. And I can't remember off the top of my head, but a lot of victories under Coach Bobby Schultz.
And as you see there, Gianna Glatz keeping the Renegades in this game. I'm sorry, making sure Cherokee doesn't get back into the game. That is what I meant to say, as Cherokee tries to get back onto an offensive possession here. As a ball played by Lindsay Florio. Looks to stick handle around her defender. It's still out in front. As Shawnee trying to clear it. As Gianna Mancini will clear the ball out to midfield. But Cherokee has something else to say, as there's a little battle going on in midfield. This will be Shawnee ball, and then there's another whistle, and then a little bit early with Shawnee, and then Cherokee will get the ball, and then Shawnee will get it right back. So both teams exchanging plays, as the ball will be sent way down the far side and out of reach for Gianna Mancini.
Now, coming off that water break, there was a little pressure there by the Chiefs, and I'm going to try to get it back down the field again.
I guess you could say that water cooled the offense down for Cherokee. But as we talk about offense, here comes Shawnee back on offense. And that is Colette.
Excusion.
Trying to get something going here for Shawnee, as she'll try to do so, but it'll be Cherokee ball. So it looks like there was a little early rush. As refs, looks like there is a card in the ref's hand, and it looks like a yellow card for Erica Solomon. I think she rushed a little bit too early on.
Right, and that's the
that free hit.
That was the second card probably for the quick restart.
As there's another whistle, and that goes against Shawnee, as here comes Cherokee now on the far side with plenty of open space. As she'll get it ahead to Christina Oreo.
Oh, Cherokee had some numbers there, but it was interrupted. But Cherokee on the defense gets it back, but goes back to Shawnee again.
So Cherokee will get the ball back here. Here's a free hit as Sabrina Solomon trying to gain possession of the ball. But Cherokee will draw a whistle as Kelly Foley tried to create something, tried to get something going for the Chiefs, but nothing happened. But there she is again, knocking down that free hit. And then that goes out to Gigi Glenning, and now it's out in front again for Cherokee. Cherokee trying to push up the offensive possession, and it'll be a penalty cross for Cherokee. So here comes Cherokee now, as they need some offense here. with 11 minutes and 56 seconds here in the second half as the Chiefs are down 3-1.
And this could be a very pivotal play if the Chiefs can pop it in here.
You need to talk about a goal scoring chance right here. They need a goal in the worst way here, as here comes the penalty cross. It comes out to Gabadine. Gabadine looking around. She tries to get a pass through as there is a whistle. And it'll be Cherokee ball as Shawnee takes it away. Now here comes Shawnee. If this gets past the Cherokee defender, but the Cherokee defender, Gigi Glenning, holding that midfield. But then now here comes Shawnee again on the attack, but the ball will go out of bounds and it will be Cherokee ball. So Shawnee again pushing up the offense, but can't get anything out of the offense possession, as it'll be Cherokee ball, as it'll be played to the far side, as it'll be taken away again by Shawnee. I'm not quite exactly sure who number 14 is on the Renegades, but
yeah,
she did have a chance to play the ball.
Yeah, I know. We checked it before, and unfortunately, she's not listed on our list that we have.
As Gianna Martini comes, she crossed in the ball. It was a really good cross. As now it's another penalty cross for Shawnee. As Cherokee now only have three players. Oh, now here comes the fourth. Now only have four players to defend this penalty cross.
Yeah, and this is with 10 minutes left. This is pivotal for the Cherokee defense to stop this.
As the cross comes in, it comes out to Solomon. Solomon will play it. It's out in front. It takes a deflection off a Cherokee defender, and it will roll wide of the net.
Yeah, it looked like possibly number 36, Lana Tunzello, got hurt on that cross, but she's a trooper. She's staying in, and she's carrying the ball now.
And so she goes as she tries to get it cleared, as it will go out on Cherokee, and now here comes Shawnee again. Shawnee will cross the ball in. It is beautifully cleared again by Lana Tunzello. This ball is played, but then it goes off a Cherokee defender's foot, as it'll be a free hit for Cherokee, but then Shawnee all over that ball again. And here they come again. Looks like Solomon should rip a shot!
Oh.
And she scores!
It looked like somehow it went into the far end or was deflected, because I don't think it went in short side. Maybe we'll see that on the replay.
So it looks like, I don't know, there is a whistle, but nothing important for the whistle, as kind of don't know who scored that goal, but I'm almost positive it was Sabrina Solomon scoring her second goal of the game. So we'll see, as it looks like a timeout has been taken, but I don't know who called it, as we see the Shawnee Renegades huddle with, as we see the Shawnee Renegades huddle with Renee Tolliver trying to rally her troops together to score more goals and keep Cherokee out of this. And as you can see here, here's Cherokee with Devin Bell. You can tell she's really intense right now. 8 minutes 54 seconds to go in this game, as she's like, Cherokee really needs to get some offensive possessions here.
Yeah, and you may see the Chiefs starting to take some chances, which sometimes results in a breakaway for the other team. And I'm sure Coach Toller is telling her team, look, there's 9 minutes left, 4-1. Don't give up your offensive attack. And we did get confirmation that number 11 got the goal for Shawnee. It's Gianna Mancini.
And also, let's take a look at the Ivy Rehab replay. Ivy Rehab Physical Therapy on the web at ivyrehab.com. As here it is. So it looked like Gianna Mancini was going to cross that in, but instead rips a shot that goes to the far corner and in. So that was a brilliant shot as Shawnee now extends the lead 4-1.
Really, and you have a goal that goes in and on a bad angle like that, you know, could be deflating for the Chiefs. But with that timeout, Coach Bell is going to tell her, okay, this is it. Around 9 minutes left. Give it all you got. Start taking some chances.
It ain't over till it's over. So.
And again, the Renegades they don't want to let up. They don't want to go back on their heels thinking they have this thing wrapped up. There's a lot of goals can be scored in a short time in field hockey.
As here we go, as Cherokee will get the offensive possession here as they'll look to try and get another goal in the second half as Shawnee's been able to shut them down in this half. And speaking of offense again, Shawnee tried to come up with another offensive possession, but it wasn't successful as Claire Flannery tried to get a piece of that as she's playing tight D against Lindsay Florio as Claire will get the steal here and she'll try and create another offensive possession as Johnny Mancini tried to get an offensive possession going, but as it's taken away, and then it goes out on Cherokee, and it'll be Shawnee ball. So Cherokee have 8 minutes left to try and get three goals to tie up this game. As here comes Shawnee again with another offensive possession. That ball will be crossed in, but it'll be cleared away by...
Looks like number 33, I believe, Zoe Musick.
I believe so. As we speaking of Cherokee, they had an offensive possession. Katie Copper got tripped up, and there was a foul called, so Cherokee has the possession again. As here comes Cherokee now. But the Shawnee defense, the Shawnee defense have been on their toes today. Only given up one goal. Great saves by their goalie.
And right, and quality scoring chances for the Chiefs have been minimal.
Yeah, the Shawnee defense, again, been holding them as, there was nearly another offensive possession for Shawnee.
And that was interrupted by number 8, Allison McGrath, for the Chiefs.
And then Katie Copper tries to get something going, but then draws a whistle, so Joe Walsh will take the chip, and that chip is really high. Thought the whistle would be called there, but I guess not, as there's the ball gets taken away there by Lindsay Florio. So Lindsay Florio and Bella Mancini are in a good battle, as Bella Mancini will win the battle. Here she comes near side, and she'll pass that ball to Erica Solomon. Erica Solomon carrying the ball up. She'll pass that ball to Sabrina Solomon. That ball is out in front, but the shot goes wide, so a good offensive possession there for Shawnee, as those passes were crisp and on point, as Shawnee again coming with the ball, as it'll be crossed in, and there's a kick save. There's another shot out in front, and it goes in.
It goes in, but the whistle...
The whistle blows.
We'll negate that score. So Cherokee still alive here with 5:40 left in the second half. Still holding a three-goal lead.
So a close call there for Cherokee. You're lucky that whistle blew, or it would have been 5-0. As here comes Cherokee now on an offensive possession, but the pass is not so crisp. And now here comes Shawnee again. Erica Solomon still carrying the ball. He's trying to weave past her defender. There's the whistle. And there will be another penalty cross for Shawnee.
And I'm sure it's in the double digits right now for Shawnee.
Number 11, I think it is. I have no idea. It's been so many. Shawnee just keeping the pace up as Ashley Wetzel will take the penalty cross here for Shawnee. Referee gives the head nod. Here comes the cross. Sabrina Solomon back to back, and then Shawnee Lawson. Now here comes Cherokee again on the offensive possession. Oh, there's a beautiful stick handling by Cherokee.
That's number two, I believe, Gab Bodine. We saw her do that earlier in the contest.
We just got word by people that Emma Altenberg is still in net for Cherokee. We're sorry about that little mishap. So Allie St. Jean is not in. It is Emma Altenberg. She has been in the whole game as Cherokee tried to get an offensive possession going, but the shot did go wide, and it'll be Shawnee ball. As Cherokee trying to get this ball, as there was some good defense by Joe Walsh, as now she'll throw the ball in, but then there's a big whiff there. Ball will be batted down out in front. It's still in. There's a shot, but there's another save by Gianna Glatz.
And that was a blistering shot, too, and an equally great save again by Gianna Glatz.
Not sure who shot that ball, but whoever did, that was a nice-looking shot as Joe Walsh tried to cross the ball in, but then it tipped off a Shawnee defender. It tipped off of number 14 for Shawnee. As it'll be Cherokee ball again. As Joe Walsh will play it back for Kelly Foley, I believe. And now here's Shawnee again as they took the ball away. There's Ashley Wessel coming on the attack. She'll pass it back to Olivia Dre as she'll pass that to Claire Flannery as Claire looks to get it to Erica Solomon, but pass is mishandled, and now here comes Cherokee again with the ball. But again, great defense again by Logan Anderson. That ball's played. That's a beautiful ball. Erica Solomon giving chase. And Erica Solomon will take the ball away. So now here comes another Shawnee of its possession. Erica moving in. She tries to circle around, and there's a whistle, and yet another penalty cross for Shawnee.
And you notice that last possession, it looked like the Renegades were really staying wide, you know, opening up the field, spreading the field with a 3-goal lead with under 2 minutes. That's the strategy that, you know, usually works and sometimes creates a break, and they certainly had a great scoring opportunity.
As Ashley Wessel throws the penalty cross in, it's out in front. That ball is taken wide open net there for a minute, as the ball will go out, and it'll be Shawnee ball again.
And I think number 7, Katie Copper, got a stick on that shot that interrupted that scoring opportunity for the Renegades.
As Charis Hickey throws it in, and then Sabrina Solomon had the ball, trying to weave through people, and now another Shawnee penalty cross. I think that's number 14 for the game. So, can Shawnee capitalize here with under a minute to go? As referee gives the head nod, and it goes out to Sabrina Solomon. She'll try and take a shot, but Katie Copper gets in front of it. And then here comes Erica Solomon. She'll try to try to get the ball up, but then Kelly Foley will have something to say about that, and it'll be a Cherokee free hit. As the ball will go out, and it will be Shawnee ball again. 22 seconds to go. As Cherokee just trying to play a little bit of defense, but here comes Erica Solomon out in front, but then she'll get the ball knocked away from her, so she's trying to get the ball back again. Whistle will blow. It'll be Cherokee ball. 2 seconds to go. And that is the game.
That will do it. Fast and furious action. Great hockey here today on a hot day. Shawnee takes home their first win of the year, 4-1.
As you said, a real fast and furious game here today for both teams. But Shawnee just had the better offensive possessions, created better offensive possessions, and got the win here today.
Right, and they certainly took advantage of those possessions as they managed to hit the back of the net four times, only one time for the Chiefs. But nonetheless, some great opportunities and great effort by a very entertaining game by both teams here on this very, very hot day.
And as we see here, Gianna Glatz with probably an outstanding performance. As there you see there, the Shawnee Renegades on their first match of the season come up with a 4-1 win over Cherokee. And as you just saw there, Gianna Glatz had a monster performance today.
Yeah, you go back to all those saves in a short time, Sam. One of those goals go in, who knows, could be a different outcome today. But she certainly had to come up big, even though the Chiefs didn't have a whole bunch of scoring opportunities. When they had them in bunches, and she stood up tall, and Gianna Glatz definitely stood up tall.
And we will be back right after this.
On LDTV Sports, sponsored by Deborah Heart and Lung Center, where experience matters. 800-555-1990. www.deborah.org. Philadelphia Wholesale Produce Market. All the best, all right here. 215-336-3003. Or on the web at www.pwpm.net. Comegno Law Group, specializing in general and special education law, representing individuals, families, public boards of education, and independent schools. 888-313-IDEA or comegnolaw.com. Medford Village Car Care, serving the area's car care needs for 30 years. Located at 11 North Main Street in Medford. 609-654-4023. And on the web at mvcc-nj.com. Rothman Institute, the official team physicians of the Phillies, Eagles, Flyers, and 76ers. For orthopedic excellence, think Rothman first. www.rothmaninstitute.com. And by Heads Up, Eyes Forward, please never drive distracted. www.lrhsd.org/heads-up. For information on how your business can become a sponsor of LDTV Sports, contact Joe Malagrana, LDTV Underwriting Manager, at 609-268-2000, extension 8680, or by email, jmalagrana@lrhsd.org.
Said it was 14. We have it on tape.
And welcome back to Shawnee High School. As there you see, Shawnee Renegades getting the 4-1 win. As we're trying to figure out the name of number 14. Can't quite get her name. But all right, so now it is time to take a look at the All-State. It is now time for the Reconstructive Orthopedics Player of the Game, 1-800-896-RECON, or on the web at www.reconstructiveortho.com. Let's send it down to Alyssa Biederman standing by for the interview.
Hi, thanks. I'm here with Deanna Glatz, who's the goalie for Shawnee. So you guys did really well on both defense and offense. So how does your team keep up such great communication?
We try to support the team from the backfield and talk about all the gaps and what we see from the back and bring it up the field one row at a time until we get to where the ball is and get to our forwards, and that's how we communicate.
Okay, and it's pushing 100 degrees, and you have a lot of protective gear on, and I know I lose focus in the heat, so how do you keep focused? You had 6 saves.
Well, my teammates, they're really supportive. They know that I have a lot of pads on and how hot it is. They know it's hot for themselves, and they can only imagine, but the communication, the support from them is really what keeps us going.
Okay, and what does this win mean for you? First one of the season.
It means a lot. It's our layout for the rest of the season, and it's a really big deal. It's a good win, beating Cherokee. They're a good team.
All right, well, congratulations, and good luck with the rest of the season.
Thank you.
As you see, Renee Tulliver talking to her team about a great win.
I'm sure she's saying, put it behind you. We got another tough game coming up and the whole year in front of us. But certainly, as Gianna said, just a great start. District rival is Cherokee, and they certainly do have a good team, and it's a good win to start for them. Gianna Glatz credited for 6 saves, and certainly was more shots, on the net. I'm sure they count on the shots being saved that would have gone in if she wasn't there. Similar to ice hockey, I'm almost assuming that. But of those 6 saves, probably took maybe 20 or 25 seconds time-wise, on the clock. That's how many shots that they had in a row. But she came up big to keep them in that game at a crucial time, and certainly deserving for our player of the game.
And now it is time to take a look at the Allstate Good Hands Play of the Game, sponsored by Michael McDyer, CLTC 609-654-1426, or Michael McDyer at allstate.com. Allstate, you're in good hands. As here is Tony Marmo with our play of the game, and look at this shot. Just absolutely rips it past the goalie.
Okay, look like from here, number 11 took the shot, Jana Mancini, and I think number 14, Tony Marmo, deflected it in. That's what it looked like from here, because I did ask some of the parents if they thought it was the goal by number 11. So I think we cleared it up, and thank you for the great work in the booth there, getting the name for number 14, who scored that 4th goal on deflection, apparently, Tony Marmo.
LDTV Sports Productions are available online at youtube.com/LenapeeDistrictTV and for purchase at www.lrhsd.org/LDTV copies. As our next game here on LDTV, we will have the Cherokee Chiefs at the Shawnee Renegades, as it will be played at Shawnee High School. And I'm actually looking forward to that matchup. Should be a good one.
Absolutely. And again, it's that would be the second end of our doubleheader here on September 9th. So looking forward to stay here in the heat and see the Cherokee Chiefs at the Renegades football.
Well, that'll do it for us here at Seneca High School. Shawnee Renegades pick up a 4-1 win over the Chiefs. We will hope to see you next time here on LDTV Sports.
Great job, Sam.
This program was produced by Lenape District Television.
Do you have a plan to increase security in places like that?
District has up-to-date and well-tested emergency response plans.